When I realized that all Macs were going to be made with the Apple Silicon chip instead of the traditional Intel chip, I went out and bought this Intel iMac as fast as I could. But why? Everyone raves about the M1, its benchmarks are incredibly impressive, and it will certainly be the chip of the future when it comes to Mac computers. So why, with the M1 chip right around the corner, was I in such a rush to get my hands on a new Intel iMac? Well, I have two main reasons, including a complete deal breaker, which I'll tell you about. The first reason, however, was because I didn't feel that the Intel iMacs were lacking in any department that I used them for or would be using them for in the near future. I edit 4K videos, I run many processor-intensive applications, and my iMac never even blinks. Apple started making computers with Intel chips in 2006 and did so until 2020, which is when I bought this iMac. I've used Intel iMacs my entire life, and there are a few things that I know about them. Although in the early days, some of them needed some expensive display replacements, overall, especially as the lineup was tweaked and as it matured, these computers are absolute workhorses that are super robust. I use both Mac and Windows, which was an important part of my decision, and I'll get to that towards the end, but it's safe to say that I've used a lot of different computers from a hardware perspective in my life, and the iMacs and MacBooks that I've used have been the most ironclad computers that I have ever used. So why would I take the risk, with quite the hefty investment, in a brand new line of computers with a brand new chip that has never been tested long term, when I could invest in a computer line that has a 15-year history of being absolute ironclad battleships? Full disclosure, I am not an early adopter. I rarely do unboxings. If you've seen any of my LinkedIn learning courses, you know that I present solutions that are tried, true, and have been battle tested. So getting my hands on an M1 just for the sake of trying it out and making content with it isn't really in my wheelhouse per se. So that's my first reason. I had fallen in love with the Intel iMacs, and the idea of not being able to get my hands on one before they discontinued making them just did not sit well with me. Secondly, there was quite a bit of discussion on whether certain applications would be compatible with the new chips, especially right in the beginning. And although I wasn't really worried about this long term, in the short term, it was something that I just didn't really want to have to deal with. So this brings me to my deal breaker reason and why I am so glad that I made the decision that I did when buying this Intel iMac. Remember when I said that I use both Mac and Windows? Well, that is very true, and I use both operating systems almost daily, but if not daily, at least weekly. One of the reasons that I love the Intel iMac so much is that with an Intel chip in Bootcamp, you can install a full version of Windows on your computer, on your hard drive. I'm not talking about using Parallels or any virtual OS or anything like that. And that Windows installation runs more smoothly than any other Windows installation that I've ever used. So when I say that I use Windows in Mac, understand that I mean I use them on the same computer, my Intel iMac, and Apple upgrading to their own silicone chip completely destroys the compatibility between Apple hardware and Windows OS. On the M1's release date, there would absolutely be no way to run Windows natively. For this, Microsoft would have to create a version of Windows programmed specifically for the Apple silicone chip. Probably their biggest competitor's chip, right? So that doesn't seem very likely. In the past, both Apple and Microsoft had programmed their OSs to work with Intel. So it was almost by luck that you were able to do this and both operating systems were able to work on the same hardware. But now the compatibility between the two seemed broken forever, and it very well may still be. You see, I recently received a comment from one of my viewers, and she said that running Bootcamp isn't an option on Mac OS Ventura. This caught my eye because I use Bootcamp on Ventura every single day. And after rereading the comment again, I realized exactly what it was. She was trying to run Bootcamp on macOS Ventura running on a silicone chip instead of an Intel chip. I honestly hadn't really thought about it that much. I've been happily using both Windows and Mac on my Intel iMac since I bought it, so it hadn't really crossed my mind. So I did some research, and sure enough, there is still no way to do it. 3 years later, when you start searching for it, you're pushed to use Parallels, which is a virtual version of Windows. And honestly, Parallels has never been and probably never will be good enough for me. So that just isn't really an option. But both on the Mac side of things and the Windows side of things, that is what they're presenting as the current best option, which is a huge step back from being able to run both Windows and Mac natively on the same hardware. If you strictly use Mac, this shouldn't really be a problem. The M1 chip seems great, but I'm going to be taking this Intel Mac setup with me as far into the future as I can go. And sure, I know that the next time I buy a Mac, it's not going to be with an Intel chip, it's going to be with a silicone chip, and then I'm probably going to have to either build a second Windows machine or maybe make a Hackintosh, we'll see. But for now, I'm going to be happily using both operating systems on the same computer with this Intel iMac. I know there are still some Intel iMacs available aftermarket, but Apple stopped selling them in 2020. So if this is something you're interested in, you may want to try and get your hands on one of those before it's too late. I'm not even really sure how many people use both OSs on the same system or if this is something that's important to you, but I wanted to share my story and give you a chance to act sooner than later. I hope you found this video interesting and helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more content like this, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for today. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.